Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 4, that is underground cables. Here we are going to discuss about that grading of cables. So let us discuss about that grading of cables. So as we know that very clear, underground cables consists of either 1 core cable or 2 core cable, 3 core cable or 4 core cable. So as to provide that a good amount of insulation, there are number of layers of insulation which was covered that core or conductors of an underground cable, like impregnated paper or insulating paper, which is covered by lead sheet or metallic sheet. Again, it is covered by bedding. Again, it is covered by armoring. Again, it is covered by serving. So there are various types of layers of insulating material which cover that underground cable as to protect that core or conductors right from atmosphere, alkalis, acids and from chemical reaction. So the process of achieving uniform electrostatic stress in the dielectric cables is known as grading of cables, because the core or the conductor which is surrounded by various layers of insulating material which have the different amount of thickness. So therefore, the electric stress or electrostatic stress on the dielectric insulating material is not to be same, that should be different based upon the thickness of or the amount of insulating material and the capacitance which was existed due to that leakage of currents. So in order to make them a uniform electrostatic stress, it has already been shown that electrostatic stress in a core cable has a maximum value of G max at the conductor surface and goes on decreasing as we move towards the sheath or as we move towards that outer layer. The maximum voltage that can be safely applied at the underground cable depends upon G maximum value, that is electrostatic stress at the conductor surface. For safe working of a cable having homogeneous dielectric, the strength of dielectric must be more than G maximum value. If a dielectric of high strength is used for a cable, it is useful only near the conductor where stress is maximum. As we know that very clear, initially the core or the conductor which covers that impregnated paper or insulating paper, which is hygroscopic, where the electrostatic stress is high. Again, it is somewhat high compared to metallic sheet or lead sheet. So like that, there is electrostatic stress which is not an uniform. But in order to make that electrostatic stress in a uniform manner as to overcome that voids on the hard insulating material, but as we move away from the conductor, the electrostatic stress decreases. So the dielectric will be unnecessarily overstrung. The unequal stress distribution in a cable is undesirable based upon the various reasons. Firstly, insulation of greater thickness is required, which increases the cable size. Secondly, it may lead to breakdown of insulation. That means it becomes so hard and it becomes voids and breakdown takes place on the insulating material. In order to overcome the above disadvantages, like the greater thickness which is required, which increases the cable size and which leads that breakdown of the insulation, so it is necessary to have a uniform stress distribution in cables. This can be achieved by distributing the stress uniformly in such a way that its value is increased in the outer layers of the dielectric. This is known as grading of cables. There are mainly two methods of grading of cables. One is called capacitance grading, another one is called as intersheath grading. Let us discuss about that capacitance grading. The process of achieving uniformity in the dielectric stress by using layers of different dielectrics is known as capacitance grading. In capacitance grading, the homogeneous dielectric material is replaced by a composite dielectric material. The composite dielectric material, as the name itself, it is called as composite dielectric material, which consists of various layers of insulating materials. The different dielectrics in such a manner that the relative permittivity, that is epsilon r, of any layer is inversely proportional to its distance from the center. As we know that very clear, as the distance is increases, that epsilon r value we can choose that should be smaller value. Then epsilon r value should be high, which is initially covered that core or the conductor. Under such conditions, the value of potential gradient at any point in the dielectric is constant, but it is independent of its distance from the center. So in other words, the dielectric stress in the cable is same everywhere and the grading is ideal one. So, however, ideal grading requires the use of infinite number of dielectrics, which is an impossible task. So, in practice, two or three dielectric materials which are used in the decreasing of order of permittivity. Because initially covered that impregnated paper or paper insulation, again it covered that metallic sheet or lead sheet. So, impregnated paper, metallic sheet or lead sheet having highest permittivity value, that is relative permittivity, as compared to outer layers like serving, armoring, whose epsilon r, that is nothing but relative permittivity value, is less. So, the dielectrics of highest permittivity being used, that should be always covered near the core or conductor. So, here I am showing that a figure. In this figure, the center of that underwound cable consists of a group of strands like aluminium or copper, whose permittivity value, whose radius value is equal small d by 2. Then the first layer which covers that group of strands like copper or aluminium strands having that a radius of d1 by 2. Then again this impregnated paper covers that lead sheet for up from the center of the conductor to up to that lead sheet or metallic sheet whose radius is small d2 divided by 2. Then again it covers that serving is another composite material, insulating material, from center of the conductor to composite material or covering insulating material, the radius is capital D by 2. In similar manner, epsilon 1 is nothing but relative permittivity of paper insulating material, which covers that initially that group of strands like copper or aluminium core or conductor. Then epsilon 2 is nothing but permittivity of lead sheet, and epsilon 3 is nothing but permittivity of covering insulating material, which is outermost layer here. And G max is nothing but the value of breakdown strength that should be having some magnitude, which is represented a pink color spikes at here. So as we move from left hand side to right hand side, there is a dielectric strength value which increases, and if you move from right hand side to left hand side, the dielectric strength value has been decreases. And x is nothing but the overall radius of the underwound cable. Therefore, the capacitance grading can be explained beautifully by referring the above figure. There are three dielectrics of outer diameter like d1, d2 and capital D, whose relative permittivities are epsilon 1, epsilon 2 and epsilon 3. Here the permittivities, that is the relative permittivity of the insulating material which is very nearer to the core or conductor, that is epsilon 1, is greater than epsilon 2, and epsilon 2 value is greater than epsilon 3, and the three dielectrics are worked out at the maintaining of maximum stress, electrical stress. Therefore, we can write that a mathematical formula. Whenever we are going to maintain that an equal amount of electrical stress, by that time we can write that mathematical formula as 1 by epsilon 1 into D is equal 1 by epsilon 2 into D1, that is equal 1 by epsilon 3 into D2. So in this scenario, we can write that the denominators as epsilon 1 D is equal epsilon 2 D1 is equal epsilon 3 D2. So whenever we are going to maintain an equal amount of voltage stress on various layers of insulating material which cover that underwound cable, so that is V1 is equal integral of D1 by 2 to D by 2. D1 by 2 is nothing but the first layer radius, and D by 2 is nothing but the radius of copper conductor or aluminium strands. So of its G into DX, where G is nothing but a uniform electrical stress. Therefore, V1 is equal integral of D by 2 to D1 by 2 into G into DX. Here we know the formula, that is G. That is integral of D by 2 to D1 by 2. G means Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1. Because here we are taken that up to that first layer of that insulating material. Therefore, we are taken into count that epsilon means we can write that epsilon naught into epsilon 1. where epsilon naught is nothing but absolute permeability and epsilon 1 is nothing but relative permeability, epsilon into epsilon 1 into x into dx. So x is nothing but the overall radius of the given conductor. So here q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 is nothing but constant. We can take into left hand side the remaining integration and its limits, like d by 2 to d1 by 2 into 1 by x into dx. So here we can write that formula like integral of 1 by x into dx. It can write as log x into log of x, that is log of base e of x, and the limits are d1 by 2 to d by 2. Therefore, the overall equation v1 is equal q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 log of base e of x into d1 by 2 to d by 2. So now I am going to substitute that limits d1 by 2 to d by 2. Now the above equation can become as v1 is equal q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 of log of base e into d1 by 2 minus log of base e into d by 2. So we can write it as log a minus log b. We can write it as a log of a by b. Therefore, v1 is equal q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 into log of base e into d1 by 2 divided by d by 2. We can write the formula as v1 is equal q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 into log of base e into d1 by 2 into 2 by d. So here 2, 2 may get cancelled and the above equation can become as v1 is equal q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 into log of base e into d1 by d. Therefore, as we know that q by 2 pi epsilon naught into epsilon 1 is equal, that become as g maximum by 2 into d. That means we can write that formula as g maximum divided by 2 into d. Therefore, from here v1 is equal g maximum divided by 2 into d into log of base e into d1 by d. Similarly, the potential across second layer we can write it as v2, and third layer we can write it as v3. Therefore, v2 is equal g maximum divided by 2 into d1 of log of base e into d2 divided by d1. And similarly, v3 is equal g maximum divided by 2 into d2 of log of base e into d by d2. So if you observe very clearly in this formula here, the value of d initially for first up to that first layer here we can take it as small d. For second layer here up to that lead sheath we can take it as d1, and for third layer where we can take it as d2. Therefore, the total potential difference between core and earth sheath is capital V is equal V1 plus V2 plus V3. Therefore, the overall formula capital V is equal G maximum divided by 2 into D of log of base E into D1 by T plus G maximum divided by 2 into D1 of log of base E into D2 divided by D1 plus G maximum divided by 2 into D2 of log of base E into capital D divided by D2. We can write the overall G maximum divided by 2 can be taken as a constant. The remaining function is D of log of base E into D1 by capital D plus D1 into log of base E into D2 divided by D1 plus D2 into log of base E into D3 divided by D2. Therefore, if the cable had homogeneous dielectric, that means uniform insulating material, then for the same values of D, capital D and G maximum, the permissible potential difference between core and earth sheath would have been V dash is equal G maximum divided by 2 into D into log of base E into capital D divided by small d. Obviously, V is greater than V dash because initial insulating material has higher electrical stress compared to next insulating material for the given dimensions of the cable. A graded cable can be worked at greater potential than non-graded cable alternatively. Graded cable can be worked at greater potential than non-graded cable. Therefore, alternatively, for the same safe potential, the size of the graded cable will be less than that of non-graded cable. The following points which may be noted at here, they are at permissible values of G maximum, which are the peak values. Therefore, all voltages in the above expression should be taken as peak values and not the RMS values. If the maximum stress in the three dielectric stress not the same, that should be somewhat different. Therefore, V is equal G1 maximum divided by 2 into D of log of base E into D1 by D for first layer. For the second layer, G2 maximum divided by 2 of D1 of log of base E into D2 divided by D1. For third layer, it becomes as G3 maximum divided by 2 into D2 of log of base E into D3 divided by D2. Therefore, the principal advantage of this method is that there are a few high-grade dielectrics of reasonable cost whose permittivity varies over the required range. So this kind of cables we can use for higher electrical stress where it is not reduces the dielectric strength and not increases that breakdown strength. Thank you.